There it is. We, you know.
Yes, Mike. And then afterwards, you know, have your family come up and take pictures.
We'll make a motion to close executive session. Close executive session, open public.
We'll make the motion.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Okay, we're gonna go to new business right now. Under B. Make a resolution. No? No?
Christine, do we have a resolution?
Yes, what we have to do is to authorize to hire Thomas and Swalba. You have to determine the salaries because he's different, comes from the department, so that's.
That's your. No, I won't. Okay, make a recommendation for the hiring of Officer Thomas Santasuazo. Pretty good, right? First time?
Very good.
It's early yet. At a salary of $79,868.26.
Starting date?
Tonight.
Effective this date.
11/7. I'll make the motion.
Happy tomorrow.
So, 11/7 would be the actual sign.
Okay, I'll make that motion.
I'll second it. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Thank you, congratulations.
Congratulations.
So you're ready, Rich?
Mm-hmm.
Take pictures, son.
You can take pictures, please.
Tell me when you guys are ready.
Mm-hmm.
Ready? Okay, raise your right hand and repeat after me. I, Thomas Santasuazo.
I, Thomas Santasuazo.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support the constitutions.
That I will support the constitutions.
Of the state of New York.
Of the state of New York.
And the United States of America.
And the United States of America.
And that I will faithfully discharge the duties.
And I will faithfully discharge the duties.
Of Village of Washingtonville full-time police officer.
Of Village of Washingtonville full-time police officer.
To the best of my ability.
To the best of my ability.
Congratulations. Okay, now's picture time for whoever.
Want to go up back under the sign?
And here we go. he won't make any bad decisions on housing. That's part of the deal.
I'm sorry.
One, two, three. That's my line.
Jen?
Hello.
Hello. There you go. I'm hungry.
Hi, Ken.
Wanna get mom?
Wanna go with mom? You sure? Please.
Get up there. That's an order.
That's one of our rules, you know?
What's that?
Bye.
Sorry.
Thank you again.
Thank you, sir.
Joe, can his mom get in a picture?
Yes.
I know.
So, well, it'll be blurry. Thank you.
Thank you.
Brian?
Yeah.
Not that way.
You dropped some. Drop the movie. No movie. Take care.
Thank you very much.
Sorry, take care. Well, we've got to keep this.
All right, that would be great.
Okay, all right, thank you.
We have a few presentations under number three. First one, Jody Lomelli, neutering and spaying of dogs and cats.
Yes. So far?
Sure.
I've never done this before. How this works?
We never do anything.
Okay, fine.
I never neutered a dog or a spay and a cat. So these are directions, right? How to do this.
Yes. So I'm here because we all know that there's an overpopulation of cats in the Washingtonville area. Anybody heard of that? Okay, so what there is a fund called the New York State Animal Population Control Fund, and it's managed by the Agriculture and Markets Bureau. And it is money set aside for municipalities and 501c3 organizations to fund spay neuter programs. So I'm here to ask the municipality village to go ahead and apply for the grants, you know, for spaying and neutering the residents' cats, and also with that to partner with the Animal Rights Alliance once we do get for it. And the program is for low-income residents, as well as anyone who has adopted this is specifically for cats, a cat from a 501c3 nonprofit organization or an animal shelter that the cat has not been spayed.
Are you with the pet owner, Jeff?
No, no, I'm sorry. I am a 501c3 cat rescue organization with OC Save Cats.
Gotcha.
Have you made this presentation to the town board at all?
No, this is my first. I don't know what the steps are. I'm just, you know, trying to introduce myself. This is what this is.
Well, yeah, also, you do have the town of Blooming Grove, which would probably be a good idea to visit as well. Mm-hmm. And you also have South Blooming Grove, which is a village, right? So you can make appointments with both of those, and I don't think the funds would matter in the sense that all three apply and if all three receive, then you can take care of each resident in each municipality in a sense.
Yeah.
So just a thought.
Yeah, so it would be like a subsidized program, where the resident would pay $25, obtain a voucher. The additional $25 would come from the grant funds. The Animal Rights Alliance would partner up, charge $50.
Where does the neutering take place?
The Animal Rights Alliance. It's called Terra, and if you see the Terra,
It's always around.
The mobiles, we can even get them to come here to the village.
So it's mobile?
We need to, yep.
They're always up to the wall.
It's a mobile spay and neuter clinic, yeah.
Yeah, okay.
How much is the grant? How much new grant?
Well, you have to apply for it, but it can be for $5,000, $10,000, you know, $5,000.
All through agriculture markets?
It's through the Agriculture and Markets Department, but it is funded and administered by the ASPCA. So they're the ones that you have to actually make application to.
The grant could be applied for more than once. So once money runs out, could we be applying?
Absolutely.
Do you have the information for the grant?
Yeah.
I bet you do.
Yeah, yeah. I did. I have a proposal from the Animal Rights Alliance, as well as, you know, different information on the program itself and what the guidelines and requirements are to apply for the grants.
You said it was geared to low income or low?
Yes, yeah, the funds will, yeah, the grant is specifically for low income.
How do they determine it when I come down with my cat? How do they know?
It's a participation in one of the following programs: food stamps, SSI, blind, disabled, low-income housing assistance, family assistance, safety net, medical assistance, or any other similar program.
So they have to show that?
They would have to show proof of residency and prove that they're, you know, they're participating in one of those types of programs, or that they have recently adopted a cat from the Humane Society or Animal Rescue that has not yet been fostered or neutered.
Does Tara have that requirement now? They don't have that requirement now, right? For the low income? In other words, when a van is parked somewhere?
No, they obtain
more money if you don't.
How much is it if I go into that van and get it?
We've done it, we've paid over. $70 just to get them spayed and neutered, and then if they need shots or whatever. It can come out to about $110 for a cat. It was just there a couple weeks ago with a cat from outside that we paid for.
Yeah, and it would be, I mean, if you get the grant, it's no cost to the taxpayer at all. You know, it's a win-win.
Yeah, can we leave this up to you, sir?
Excuse me?
Can we leave this all the information?
Yeah, I had given Dan the information, but I have no problem going and copying everything again and sending it over. The issue is just applying, you know, making application for the grant. So I don't know, you know, if you have somebody on that does that, or, you know, I certainly would be able to help. It's basically statistics, you know.
Is there a deadline?
No, it's ongoing. It's ongoing. Once you make application for the grant, it should be about 3 months. You know, the whole entire process.
Your whole contact information.
Yeah.
So the cats have to make their food stamps first. And this is not
should be no brain not.
Well, feral cats can be in part of the program also. You know, so you just have to, you know, be participating in one of these programs. I mean, we have a lot of senior citizens here. You know, you have a lot of cats in Stonehill, Rocky Knoll, Rocky Point. You know, there's a lot. And these people, you know, are caring for the cats on their own. They're spending their own money. So, you know, getting spayed and neutered, these outdoor cats.
Yeah.
You know, and these are, you know, people who are on fixed incomes.
Can
that's
really.
Yeah.
Can the municipality take advantage of this? Or is it just for homeowners? Because they actually have
there's a whole nother program.
Okay.
There's a whole nother grant that the Humane Society can apply for.
Right, okay.
You know, but this would not be through the Humane Society or for the Humane Society. This is specifically for the residents.
Okay.
And would they do it in the van? Would the van come to do them, or would they have to go
So what would happen is the resident would come here, okay, give their $25. Tara will supply town clerk or whoever with vouchers, okay? $25, they get a voucher. They make their own appointment with Tara. They bring the voucher to Tara. It's done at the end of the month. Tara then bills the municipality for the $50. You get $25 already from the resident, and then you take $25 out of it.
So where's Tara? Where would you go? Where would they go?
Well, they it's located in Middletown. The building, the van, there's one in Newburn on Monday, Monroe on Tuesdays, Middletown on Wednesdays, I think it's a lot. or, you know, we could even get them to come here to the village, you know.
Yeah, because so many people.
Yeah, it would be easier.
Don't have transportation.
Tara also has transport. You can also set.
Oh, yeah?
Yes. You know, so it's just a matter of, you know, applying. Spring is coming, there's been a lot of kittens out there. You know, by the time spring comes back around, so the sooner we can do this, the better.
Questions?
Good, thank you. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Okay, second presentation, James Gazzazza, Solar Farm.
Good evening. Brian Irving is here from Community Energy, and he has the maps of the information.